This could be a quick video. This would be devlog zero. No coding would be done. I'm gonna make a tower defense game. This would be my second. My first one was a 2D platformer named Stickman Fighters. Basically, you fight different enemies. The score of the game was who reached the furthest. No story. There's really no story behind it. There's an online, which I was making. It's there. I just gotta update it. Not update it, but yeah, fix some bugs. Let me say that. There's bugs. But besides that, it's pretty fun. Now, as for this, this one, I use some inspirations from Dungeon Defenders. That's my best PlayStation. That's my best tower defense game. I played it on PlayStation 3 way back. I have a screenshot, right? Yeah. So this is how the game is gonna look. I hope it looks like this by the time I finish. So basically, the enemy will be spawning off the screen, and they'll be moving upwards towards a barricade. That's if you are barricades there. The barricades are gonna hinder the enemy movement, so the enemy has to destroy the barricades to reach to the castle. The castle is gonna have its own set of HP. It's like the game Pro Castle. I don't know if you played it. It's a horizontal game. I haven't played it. I just saw videos on it. It's a horizontal game. Horizontal tower defense. I'm making a portrait. Yeah, portrait, vertical, whatever. So the enemies have to get past the barricades to destroy the tower and game over. So you place barricades. This barricade here does damage, has less HP. This one does damage, does more damage, knocks back the enemy, but has way less HP. This barricade would, it does nothing but has a lot of HP. That's for ballasting purposes, etc. There will be different type of barricades. Then there's then there's gonna be towers. Towers takes no damage, but it does damage, takes no damage. Then there's two forms of currency, coins and what you call it, scraps. You basically gain scraps by killing the enemies, and you use the scraps to build the towers. So you start off with, most likely you're starting off with 0 or 1,000, somewhere around there. I'm not sure yet. I haven't worked it out. Close that. I set up a prototype. The only thing I worked so far in was the display manager. For this, the display manager is used to find the best aspect ratio. It resizes the game screen to the aspect, resizes the game screen to the device aspect ratio. I don't know. Too confusing for me. It's basically a copy cut and paste. Yeah, it's basically a cut and paste thing from Pixelated Pope Video. Aspect ratio, should watch it. Press play. GameMaker Live. Yeah, if y'all are wondering what this is an extension I'm using. It's live coding. It comes with the extension on a server for, again, live coding. Now where you can say, usually you would have the write this variable. Let's see, it. Say you write a variable it equals 0. Inside the, wherever this piece of code is, whilst the game is running, you could edit it, and it would equal, say, 9. It would be equals 9. But since this is in the create event, you have to restart it, or this object has to get recreated for that to take effect. So it's really useful in situations like inside the step event, where you have to do live, where the step is all getting updated, where you can edit. Where the step is always getting updated, so you can re-edit the code and etc. Like placing a GUI, finding a certain position, changing the color, etc., etc. It goes on. But see, here's the demo. So basically, the red squares, you click on it, you place a barricade, hinders the enemy movement. So far, nothing happening. This right here, this would be the castle, that'll be the HP. Enemy hits the castle, castle takes damage. You click on the grand spot, you click on a grand thing, I'm like that, grand slot, you place a turret, the turret hits the, kills the enemy. Something simple, casual game. That would be it to show.